Ye Wubin's 100 Lessons to Mastering Time Management. Lesson 11. Do one thing at a time. Hello everyone, my name is Ye Wubin from Easy Efficiency. I am so happy to be with you now at 6 a.m. on the Ximalaya app. For those of you who have been following my lessons, welcome back. And if you're new here, welcome aboard. I'm so happy to have you with us. Time is man's scarcest resource. Once it's used, it can never be regained. So if you're not using your time effectively, or if the time you're spending is only getting you farther away from your dreams in life, then stay with me. Listen a while, and I'm confident I can help open your eyes to a new path that will get you closer to your dreams. Today's focus is to devote yourself to one thing at a time. We can only do things well if we devote our energy and focus to that task. To complete a task, to the best of our ability, we must attend to it with our heart and soul. So when an item is on your list or schedule, and it is time to complete it, devote your full energy and attention to it. Let me tell you a story. Bill Gates, the founder of Microsoft, and the richest man in the world, and Warren Buffett, the most successful investor in the world, were both asked, "What is the key to success?" They didn't answer out loud. Instead, they wrote 5 letters on a piece of paper. Focus. The word that they spelled was focus. In our lives, we must do things that we wish to accomplish. We must focus on our goals in order to do this. In order to clear a list of the many items we need to accomplish, we must be efficient. And to be efficient, we must complete tasks quickly and effectively. In order to do this, we must focus our full attention and energy to each individual task. However, during our lives, we are constantly distracted by things around us, which threaten to steal our focus and energy from the task we need to devote it to. Think of the last time you opened your computer or phone to complete an important task. What was the very first thing you did? Did you go right to that task? Or did you stop to check your email or text messages? Did you check your WeChat or Facebook? And when you did this, how long were you distracted? It is in this way that time is slowly taken from the task we need to use it for and given to those unimportant, unurgent activities. These bits of activity steal valuable time that we need to devote to the tasks in front of us. Can you see how it really is not that we have no time, but that we don't use the time that we already have effectively? Now let me tell you how you can use the time you have to focus on the things you need to get done, which is this. If you want to increase the efficiency of your work, then first, increase the density of the time you devote to each task. If you now spend 1 hour to complete a task, ask yourself, how can you complete it in half that time, or even just 10 minutes, with the same quality result? This is what I mean by increasing the density of the time you devote to each task. This intense focus and devotion to our tasks is not something we should do 24 hours a day. You should only do this when you are focusing on your tasks. So how exactly do we devote our energies? What is the secret? The secret, of course, is to do one thing at a time. But how do we convert this idea into practice? What specifically should we do? I'm going to share with you a powerful method that people have used all over the world. Over the past 3 years, I've taught over 300 time management courses to a live audience. I wanted my students to learn more and more in a shorter and shorter time. And to do this, I asked them to do one thing. I asked them to eat the tomato. Yeah, you heard me right. I said eat the tomato. Okay, I don't actually mean eating a real tomato. I mean using a special device called a Pomodoro clock. And what is a Pomodoro clock? Actually, it's a clock used for counting down time. It's a timer. It was used in the past to count down the time needed to make tomato sauce or pomodoro sauce. For example, if you needed to cook soup for 30 minutes, you would twist the pomodoro clock to the 30-minute mark and let it count down. When it reached zero, it would ring, letting you know that time is up. The inventor of the technique was a cook working out of a kitchen all day long, and over time he began to see that he could only focus his energies for a short amount of time before his energy began to weaken, and he was unable to concentrate any more on the single task he was working on. That's the reason why this time management technique is now called the Pomodoro technique. This man found that if he spent too long concentrating on a task, he would get to a point where he could no longer focus on any task for even a few minutes because he became tired. So I want you to try something. See how long you can focus on a single task without becoming distracted or losing focus. Start small, focus for 15 minutes first before resting, then 25 minutes, then 45 minutes, and gradually increase the time you spend focusing on your tasks one by one. You can use the actual Pomodoro countdown clock, or some of its variations like the Apple or Pear countdown clocks, and you can buy these on Taobao or Amazon. You can also use your mobile phone's timer functions, if you wish. Set the time to 25 minutes. Then, during these 25 minutes, devote yourself fully and completely to the task in front of you. Don't eat. Don't drink. Don't use the bathroom. Don't use your mobile phone. Don't do anything but what's needed to complete your assigned task. Try it today. What do you have to lose? It's just 25 minutes. Now make sure you don't eat or drink or use the bathroom during these 25 minute periods. In order to do that, you must prepare yourself beforehand and have that drink or use the bathroom before or after that 25 minute period. It is critical that you do not let yourself become distracted during these 25 minute periods. And after the 25 minute period is up, give yourself 5 minutes to rest, have a drink, use the bathroom, relax, then begin another 25 minute session of intense concentration. Continue to repeat these cycles of 25 minutes of work and 5 minutes of rest. And as you do this more and more, you will find that you can do more and more in those 25 minutes. As you begin, you may only complete 50% of your task during the 25 minutes. But as you practice and become more efficient in the technique, you will get 75% done in a single 25 minute period, or even 100% of your task. This is called the Pomodoro technique. Now at first, many of my students will ask, "Mr. Ye, I've seen the Pomodoro technique. It's nothing more than repeating cycles of 25 minutes work, 5 minutes rest. It's too simple. It's too boring." Well, in fact, they're right. The technique is indeed very simple. But remember what we talked about in an earlier lesson. The best way to achieve great things is usually the simplest way. And this technique is really quite simple. It is normal to feel this way. Often, we are unwilling to do the simple things. But when we accept a more complex method, like the GTD method, we are overcome with how complex and large it seems. In the end, it really is just an excuse. And this excuse and unwillingness to do the simple things, to change your habits and bring out the full potential in each and every minute of your life, is one of the key reasons people fail in their ambition to become better managers of their time. So today, give it a try. Learn how your mind and your actions are affected by this technique. You may not be perfect at first, but work on it. Devote your energy to it, and adapt and improve each time. Write down what works and what doesn't. I have been using this technique for years. In fact, I'm using it at this very moment to create these lessons on Ximalaya for you. And after so many years of practice, the technique is very easy for me. So if you're ready to start training in this technique, please do it exactly as explained before. 25 minutes on, 5 minutes off. It won't be easy at first, but over time you will turn this skill into your habit, and what was once a difficult method will become as easy as your brain becomes accustomed to it. You will be amazed at just how much you can accomplish in a single 25-minute span of time if you focus your energy into that single task. So in summary, remember today's topic: do one thing at a time. Only when you focus your energies into a single task can you not only get things done, but get things done well. And by doing this, you will eliminate the fogs from your life, complete the tasks on your lists, and complete the goals you have created for yourself, and eventually achieve the life you've always wanted for yourself.